This is the only AI tool you will ever need. I created 40 realistic images in just 6 minutes. This can definitely help you save time and effort. Let's get straight to the point. In this video, we'll be looking at AI tool called Veras. You can use in SketchUp, Revit, Rhino, and Web. After you install the Veras, you can see the plugin EvolveLab at top. I set 5 different camera angles to show you the power of Veras. Outdoor facade, living room, kitchen, bedroom, and children's room. We need to adjust the graphic display setting first, so that Veras can perceive the visual better. Style to realistic, turn off show edges. Because Veras creates its own light source, set the sun to 0, choose a gradient for a background. Now we can start the Veras. On the first page, you can see the default template for your design. Each of them owns specific prompts and settings. We will only adjust the width and height from here because we will customize our settings according to our design. The first one is geometry override. The amount of geometry will change from the original level, as you can see in the visual. Material override is low values closer to original aesthetic, high values producing more dynamic colors. These are related to current camera angle of your design. We will use prompt to generate specific rendering. We can set the prompt strength in here. I will explain about seed and refine later in the video. It will be better to explain it with an example. At the right bottom, we adjust how many frames of the image will be created when I press the render button. To show an example, let's first look at how to get an image without writing a prompt. It created a realistic visual as far as it could perceive the materials in the Revit project. Specify which settings are more suitable for your design in the comment section and we can discuss about it. I usually use 20, 30, and 90 to stay true to the original geometry. You can customize it for your own project here. I like this one. To move on to the next render frame, we select the camera angle we want from Revit. After pressing the I button, we press the refresh button and we adjust the width and height from the render frame. This time, we click on interior. I like this one, but paintings on the wall are not fully rendered. I press the seed button to take this render frame as a reference, and then I add a prompt and click render. As you can see, nothing changed in render except the painting. Now it's better. This time, I click on the Refine tab and select the area I want to be recreated. I just write the microwave and click Render. Now it's better. If you found this content useful and do not want to miss upcoming videos about 3D visualization, don't forget to like and subscribe. We need to use the Refine tool again. You can reach the design phase of this house in Revit here. See you in the next video.